Any trip to the vet is always quite daunting for an owner and also the pets, but I think more so for the owner because they understand what's going to be happening. The best thing to do is try and, when you first get a pet, try and get them used to coming to the vets. So most vets will be very happy with you just calling in, popping your dog on the scales maybe, getting a treat from the receptionist, and then just leaving again. The other thing is if you have multiple pets, when you bring one, if it's not too much of a hassle, then try and bring the other one with you so that they see that not every time they come, and not every time they come into that consult room, they get given something or they have to get on that table. They just are there as a mate for their friend when they come in. The other things you can use would be if your pet is really, really stressed about coming to the vets, you can get anti-anxiety supplements that will just chill them out a little bit. Adaptil is a drug or a pheromone that is made for dogs, and that comes in the form of a collar, an Adaptil collar that releases pheromones. You can also get sprays, so if your dog is coming in a carrier, you could spray the carrier with this pheromone. And the pheromone that the Adaptil has is a relaxing, calming pheromone. It's harvested from a lactating bitch, so it reminds dogs of when they were in that safe environment of a puppy, and they just feel a little bit more secure. So if your dog is anxious about coming into the vets, maybe give them an Adaptil collar and just see if that just takes the edge off that anxiety. There is also a product that you can use for cats as well, so it may be worth looking into that if they are really, really anxious about coming. The other thing to consider is when you're in the waiting room, most waiting rooms will have a separate dog and cat area, and try and sit in those areas because it is really frightening for a cat if they've got a dog just looking straight into the cat carrier at them. What we have is a cat carrier tower because the other thing that has been acknowledged is that cats do not like being on the floor. They like to be up high. So when people come in, they can put their carriers up on our cat tower and then they can feel a lot safer because they're above the height of any dogs that might be in the waiting room and above the height of people. They just feel a little bit calmer. The other thing with cats is that if you have an open carrier, so a wire one that isn't solid sides, bring a towel or something with you from home that you can cover that up with. Again, if they are frightened, the last thing they want to be is to feel exposed in an open carrier. So those are all just little things that you can try and think of. The best thing to do is just to come in, get your pet used to coming to the vets and make them feel comfortable. So the best way I feel to get a cat into a cat carrier is to put the carrier vertically with the door open if you've got one that has a front door at the front of it. So some of the cat carriers are these wire ones where they lift up from the top. They're much easier to get the cat into, but I don't think the cat feels as secure because it's all open. So the cat carriers where you've got the door at the front, I put it on the up on its end, and then I lower the cat in backwards so it's not seeing where it's going. If you try and put a cat in forwards into a cat carrier, if it doesn't want to go, it's not going to go. But if you lower in them in backwards and you do it so that if you do it on a table where they can still feel the ground or the table, they will resist more. But if you're just holding them and you lower them straight into the carrier, normally, 9 times out of 10, there's no problem at all and they just go in quite happily.